I know all of you love storytelling. You all tell stories to your parents, to your friends, and many of you must have learned stories from your teachers and grandparents. But if you want to make a career in animation, you need to understand few things, that animation is the only form of storytelling which cuts across all boundaries, cultures, languages, ages. It's the only form of storytelling which is ageless. You see Tom and Jerry, you see Mickey Mouse, you see any of the animation shows. Those were created in 1960s, 70s, 80s. You still see them, and you'll still see them for the next hundreds of years. And that's the uniqueness of the storytelling. And that's one of the reasons it's one of the most difficult form of storytelling. We have seen the making. It's a great thing that you are being able to expose yourself to making a short film. But no sooner you go into making a proper film or a proper show. In animation, a lot of thinking has to be done beforehand. The pre-visualization, the daydreaming is extremely important. At the same time, the audience to which you're going to tell your stories, they're not local audience in animation, they're always global audience. And that's one of the reasons you need to do thorough research on every subject that you deal with in telling a story to the world. Moreover, animation is the only form where you can actually create a complete visual part, and the audio can be dubbed into any language and you will not be able to tell that this was not created in this particular language. And that's one of the reasons it offers you even more flexibility. But as you go around, and if you want to make a serious career into this space, I would only like to give you three short advices. And these three short advices will not be taught to you in your school, not taught in your curriculum, not taught to you by anybody. But if you cannot do these three, you will mind it that you will never be able to make yourself as a great professional in this space. First thing that I would like all of you to do is to have an A3 size drawing book. And people might say, I do digital animation, or I do this animation, I do Maya software or 3DX software or Toon Boom or any software. But software will come much later. You cannot learn Photoshop and become a painter. You have to be a painter first to use Photoshop effectively. And that's one of the reasons. What you would do is you would take a paper and a pencil and create whatever you see inside the house and outside the house alternate days. And you continue to draw. And if you are able to draw that continuously for about years and years, that you would have an observation skill and a hand and the mind connect. And that is your riyaz to become an animator. That's the first step. The second step that you would do is that I know all of you have smartphones and you have cameras in your smartphones. You would take 5 pictures inside the house and 5 pictures outside the house. You know, for a painter, can you tell me what is the most important thing for a painter? Can anybody tell me? Can anybody tell me what is the most important thing for painting? Or for a painter? Sorry, saying being sensitive, anybody else? Sorry? Composition, sorry, saying composition. What about the students? Color is most important, yes. So let me tell you, friends, that I told you that I'm going to tell you a few things which nobody will teach you. The most important thing for a painter is a source of light. And if you can understand where is the source of light, you can do the best of the composition. You can have the best of the frame that sir was talking, Regisseur was talking about. And to understand that, you need to start taking pictures. And every 15 day, whatever number of pictures you have taken, 10 pictures into 15 days, 150 pictures, you would edit and throw away 149 pictures and keep only one best picture every 15 days. And that is the way you would learn what is the best source of light and what is the best composition that you can actually come up with. And the third exercise that you want to do, if you want to become a professional in animation is all of you have to stand in front of a mirror, a full grown mirror, and all of you have to start acting for 20 minutes to 30 minutes every single day. Make faces in front of a mirror, stand in front of a mirror, dance in front of a mirror, deliver a dialogue in front of a mirror. And if you are not able to do that, you will never be able to become an animator, because animator at the end of the day is the best actor. And in animation, whether it's a dinosaur, dog or a cat or a mouse or a mic or a pen or a water bottle, everything can become a character. And all of them have human expressions. And all of them will talk. And that makes it so difficult than live action, that you need to imagine how a bottle will talk, how a bottle will make an angry face, how a bottle will become happy. And that's one of the reasons, that imagination that you need to do. If you cannot stand in front of a mirror and act it out yourself, you would never be able to do it. And if you can do 1.5 hours of riyas, of drawing every day for 30 minutes, taking photographs every day for 30 minutes, and acting in front of a mirror for 30 minutes, I can tell you one thing, whether it's Disney, Warner Brothers, Pixar, or any of the studios in the world, they will not be able to reject you. You will always be able to be the best animation storyteller. I have learned this hard way. I go to every university, I go to every town to promote animation career, as well as, you know, comics, nowadays even AR, VR. But anybody who thinks that they can start working only on computer and become an animator or become a visual effects artist, you are absolutely wrong. Please have an observation skill, hand and the mind connect, draw it yourself, act it out yourself, and make sure that you have studied it well and watch the films 1,000 times, not to entertain yourself, but to see the grammar of storytelling, but to see the composition, but to see the editing. I know all of you must have seen a movie called Three Idiots. Have you seen?
Yes.
How many of you have seen 3 times? How many of you have seen 10 times? I would like you to see that film once again and see the genius of Raju Hirani, because he is a graduate of editing. And he has edited that film in such a beautiful way that when he takes you into the past and when he takes you into the present, you are never sure. You're so, he has taken the whole storytelling so smoothly from past to the present and from present to the past. And that's the skill of editing. So editing is not about just cutting the frame and pasting the frame. It's about storytelling. And I would like to congratulate all of you, because you have made up your mind to be a part of an industry, a very vibrant industry, and which is actually growing multifold because of the digital storytelling and the digital content economy that is happening. If we don't put out our content, we will be the losers. So I would like more and more people from India to put up their content into the digital economy that is actually ruling this world at this point in time. But please be sure that you've done right research for the story that you're going to tell. You've created the masterpiece. If you have not created a masterpiece, don't put it out, because people will remember you for what you have created and what you have shown, because your stories are going to exist beyond your existence or existence on this earth. And that's one of the reasons. Please be sure that you are telling the best stories to the world. And I only would like to wish all of you a very best and welcome you all to the animation industry. Thank you very much for being here.